right, we're gonna do one more. Sled.
Sled.
Sled and kite.
At the beginning, some of the high schoolers are very reserved, especially with telling the preschoolers no. That is a huge growth for them to be able to say no or redirect them. I think everybody in here is learning, and that is really cool to see.
Good job, guys.
At Fauquier High School, we offer career readiness classes, helping kids get into the workforce and get an idea of what they like to do. We have a program where students get to be the teachers in an in-house preschool. It's nice for them to get experience now. You don't really learn until you're in the classroom and working with the kids.
I want to be an elementary school teacher. Seeing how the kids interact with each other, interact with their environment, it really helps me put into perspective what I'm going to be setting myself up for in the future, and it really gets me excited.
And you have all of your books? When my high school students come in, we discuss what we're going to be doing that day. Everybody's going to be responsible for different things, so we make sure that we're clear on what everybody's job is that day. And today, Kate, you're going to do the computer part, and then Clara was going to do Starfall. Then when it's time, we walk out and we meet the parents and the kids. Everybody, for the most part, is happy. Sometimes we have a few tears. Often we do centers when they come in. A lot of our centers focus on fine motor skills, so they might be working with Play-Doh, they might be working with little blocks, they might be working with the magic pad, so writing names, and then they switch.
It kind of looks like a letter, huh?
It's X.
X. Good job. Let's try and make it.
I wait a little bit of time before I pair up the high schooler with the preschooler because I like to get to know the personalities.
At the beginning of this year, I was not really sure how to interact with the kids, not really sure what's the difference between hanging out with them and teaching them. I feel more confident now. I feel like both of them feel really comfortable with me.
You have to understand their basics of development. Each kid has a different personality. Sometimes you need to be a little more patient. If they're not listening, try to just give them another option and get them to what they're supposed to be doing. After the centers, we'll go down to the carpet.
We'll do some songs to get some wiggles out.
H-I-J-K-L-M-N-O-P. And then we do letters of the week. So each teacher is assigned a letter.
All right, today we are gonna do the letter L. Can someone tell me what the letter L sounds like again?
Oh. Nice work.
Oh. Lemon.
Lemon, good job.
It's up to that teacher to decide what their craft is gonna be and what books for each day.
Do ladybugs fly?
Yes.
Today we made a ladybug because we're learning the letter L.
So I think having designated weeks really helps you feel in control.
I like to give them a chance to take the lead, and I am trying to step back as time goes by.
Point to where you want your spots.
Right here.
We're out here.
Ms. Nye helps the high schoolers feel like they are in charge. She gives a lot of power to us to help the kids, but at the same time, she doesn't let anything go past her.
I have the magic teacher eyes, right? You see everything that is happening. So I will often see if I feel like they're handling the situation, but sometimes I'll step in and say, do you need help?
Teachers, you should not be doing all the cleaning.
Hey, can you put those in the table?
They can help you.
I really have seen the changes throughout all the kids in the class. Most of them are getting more out of their shell.
Fridays, we do a lot of debriefing, like what went well that week, what we need to work on, what they've noticed in their children, how they've grown, and how they've grown too.
All the four-year-olds at my table are getting much better at talking to each other.
That's
like
nice.
Conversations.
Good. I feel that with my high schoolers too. Like, this is the time of year when that happens. Like, as a teacher, this is the time of year when things start to seem to come together and then you have to say goodbye. I love teaching. I don't sugarcoat it. It's a hard career and I tell them that, but it's so rewarding. We need good teachers more than ever. So I just hope that I can guide them into that.